NBC's regular programming will not be seen this morning, so the National Broadcasting Company can kick off the holiday season live from New York City with the spectacular 70th annual Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. City, you are hovering in a helicopter above New York Harbor and the Manhattan skyline. Join us today as we move uptown for the National Broadcasting Company's telecast of the 70th annual Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. And now, from famous Herald Square, your hosts, Katie Couric and Willard Scott.
Thanksgiving, everyone. Have we got a parade for you all this morning? We've got floats and giant balloons, clowns, bands, stars, all that, and Willard Scott, too.
You got me, and John Pardo, a legend, one of the great names in broadcasting as an announcer. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
I like you. My nose is running. Anyway, we're back, and so is that certain feeling that always arrives with the Macy's Parade, especially on this, the 70th anniversary of this great New York tradition. We have our typical crisp November day. It's about 75 degrees. It's warm. There's no wind.
Yeah, right, Willard.
And I lie like a rug.
I can't believe how fast this year has gone, but that's a good thing when it means getting back to Herald Square and all that goes with it. And once again, our good friend and colleague, Al Roker, is up at the parade starting line.
And he's freezing his frontal system off up there, let me tell you. They should be off and marching any second now, Kitty, so let's go uptown. Thanksgiving, everybody. We're here at 77th Street in Central Park West, where it's all about to happen. And the wonderful lady who makes it all happen is right here, ready to go. The producer of Macy's big events, Jean McFadden. Jean, hi.
How you doing, Al?
Great.
Boy, we are going to have the biggest 70th anniversary parade we've ever had. We have so many spectacular new balloons, floats, celebrities, clowns. It is going to be a great one with over 4,000 Macy employees. Believe me, stepping off this parade is always a thrill, but today it's 70 times better.
Well, I've got a big question for you, Jean.
Sure.
Can we start?
I thought you'd never ask. Let's do it.
Hey, Katie and Willard, you guys ready?
We can't wait.
All right.
Okay, you ready to help me with the countdown?
I'm ready, Jean.
Everybody ready?
From New York City, the National Broadcasting Company presents the 70th annual Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade with fabulous balloons, spectacular floats, marching bands from across the country, Broadway's hit musicals, and your favorite stars. With your hosts, from NBC's The Today Show, Katie Couric, Willard Scott, and Al Roker. From stage and screen, Sarah Jessica Parker, Lou Diamond Phillips, news radio star Phil Hartman, Andy, Matthew, and Joey Lawrence, Caroline in the Cities, Lea Thompson, from Days of Our Lives, Deidre Hall, from the Broadway hit Chicago, Bebe Neuwirth, this year's Tony winner, Donna Murphy, The John Larroquette Show's Liz Torrance, Shirley Jones, Tony Winner, Savion Glover, from Something So Right, Jere Burns, Harry Lewis, comedian Elaine Boozler, recording stars, the legendary Kenny Rogers, superstar Vanessa Williams, Grammy winners, the Captain and Tennille, and from the Broadway stage, the casts of The King and I, Rent, Bring in the Noise, Bring in the Funk, Chicago, and the Radio City Music Hall Rockettes. Your favorite character balloons, including the debut of Peter Rabbit and Rocky and Bullwinkle. Plus, the world champion New York Yankees. Olympic gold medal winners, ice skater Oksana Bayul and gymnast Dominique Dawes. Miss America 1997, Tara Holland. And Disney's 101 Dalmatians. And to cap it off, that holiday superstar, Santa. All coming your way on Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
That Pardo is something else. Welcome, welcome. The parade is on the move uptown, but here in Herald Square, it's definitely fiesta time. When you get a load of this glitter and color, dancers and 15-foot-tall puppets, this is going to be, I mean, a Saco Bafo parade. It's really on the move uptown. Check it out.
That's right, Willard. Mike Miller and Associates presents the Macy's Parade Dance Team. Our 600 award-winning dancers have been assembled from all 50 states and Canada for this spectacular number, staged by Laura Davis and Lisa Fortenberry. They're coming at us right now with a brand new day.
Hit it, Tiger.
NBC's telecast of Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade is being sponsored in part by Wrangler, real comfortable jeans, Ocean Spray. There's nothing like the taste of Ocean Spray, so crave the wave. Fujifilm, Fujifilm, a new way of seeing things. And by Cotton Incorporated, who wishes you and your family peace and joy in the holiday season. Cotton, the fabric of our lives. More spectacular floats and bands, plus Bebe Neuwirth in a number from the Broadway musical Chicago, when Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade continues.
Welcome everybody back to the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. Parade now is at 74th Street and Central Park West, making its way toward Herald Square. And you're looking at the ice cream balloon, and behind it, we've got the M&M's chocolate balloon. It's the chocolate colorworks balloon provided by M&M Chocolate Candies. And it's got the Lawrence brothers, Matthew, Andrew, and Joey Lawrence. And with me right now, I'll tell you, Sarah Jessica Parker. You know her, of course, from everything. She was once an Annie on Broadway. She's now in the revival of Once Upon a Mattress. Sarah Jessica Parker, happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving to you too, Al.
Now, you've been all over. What is New York and Thanksgiving mean to you?
Oh, it's one of those great days where it's extremely special to be a New Yorker, to be the host of this, you know, be the host city, and it's very romantic. It's autumnal, it's family, it's cold, it's wonderful, it's all those things.
Oh, with the emphasis on cold. And speaking of romance, how are you and your significant other, Matthew Broderick, going to be spending the holiday?
We'll be spending it with our respective families eating a lot and hopefully sleeping as well.
There you go. Well, again, good luck in Once Upon a Mattress.
Thank you.
Okay,
thank
Sarah Jessica Parker, thanks a lot. Katie and Willard, what's the good word downtown?
Hey, Albert, you're a regular entertainment tonight. You get all the big stuff. They're hanging out the windows watching this parade up here. The excitement is building, and you can really feel it. And we're waiting for that special parade to hit Broadway. In the meantime, looks like the action's right here at Herald Square.
That's right, Willard.
We
may be here in the Big Apple, but Chicago is everybody's kind of town, and the Bob Fosse Classic is everybody's kind of musical. Jazzy, hot, and loaded with fabulous songs by Kander and Ebb. As Lilith on Cheers, she was kind of uptight. Now, Babelicious, Bebe Neuwirth, and the cast of Chicago bring us the showstopper, All That Jazz.
Babelicious.
Why don't we paint the town? And all that jazz, I'm gonna bruise my knees and roll my stockings down. And all that jazz, start the car. I know a whoopee spot where the gin is cold, but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl. And all that jazz. Is gonna blow the blues. And all that jazz. Hold on, hug. We're gonna bunny hug. I bought some aspirin down at United Drugs in case you shake a heart and want a brand new start to do that jazz. And all that jazz. Watch out. Jazz. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all that jazz. Find a flat, we're playing fast and loose.
And all that jazz.
Right up here is where I store the juice.
Oh, she's gonna shimmy to her daughter.
Stick around for Big Bird and Barney, real life stars, and the noise and the funk. Coming up next, all live here on NBC.
And welcome back, everyone, to the 70th annual Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. The parade is moving right along. At this minute, it has reached 66 in Central Park West. A lot of stars come out to enjoy the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade every year. In fact, there's Molly Shannon, one of the bright lights on NBC's Saturday Night Live, right on cue. Let's check in with Al Roker to see what else is happening uptown.
Thanks, Katie. I'm here with Lea Thompson from NBC's Caroline in the City. Happy Thanksgiving, Lea.
Oh, thank you so much.
Now, you're getting ready to go 20,000 leagues under the sea in this fantastic sea venture float. And for you, this is a kind of return home in that you worked in New York before. Did you ever come, you got your career started, did you ever come to the parade?
Yeah, I've been to the parade. I've never been in it, and I'm really excited because it's just the best.
Now, you've got two little girls.
Mm-hmm.
They're
going
to watch Mommy in this thing.
Mm-hmm.
You want to say hi to them?
Hi, Madeline. Hi, Zoe. I miss you.
Oh, where are they watching from?
L.A.
Okay, where it's a lot warmer.
Yeah.
Okay, well, Caroline, Lea Thompson from Caroline in the City, thanks for being with us as you make your way down Herald Square in this beautiful float. Hey, and speaking of Herald Square, I got a forecast for downtown. We're talking about a lot of noise, a lot of funk, and a lot of tapping throughout the Northeast, especially down at Herald Square. How'd I do, guys?
Great prediction, Al Roker. A total of four Tony Awards went to the show that celebrates the history of the beat. One of the winners is the choreographer and star Savion Glover, the tap dance kid himself. Here now is Savion and the cast of the Public Theater's hit Broadway musical, Bring In Da Noise, Bring In Da Funk.
Hey! hopping, back into a batting song, don't stop playing. Lindy hopping, West Coast bumping, songs and chica, hustle, cake and twist and jerk, and he's a bringing, bagging on a tune of bump. And when you bring the noise, you gotta bring the funk.
When the Macy's Parade returns, Vanessa Williams, the King and I's Lou Diamond Phillips, and much, much more. Join our royal celebration.
And welcome back, everybody. You're looking down on Parade Day in New York City as the parade marches around Columbus Circle. A beautiful morning in New York where the weather is what, Willard?
It's 29 degrees and climbing.
Slowly. Slowly. Incidentally, a few days ago, we traced the route of the parade from a helicopter with the help of one of Saturday Night Live's most famous alums. He's one of the stars of the NBC series News Radio, Bill Hartman.
Ah, the Big Apple. Used to live here. Love it. Let's see it from a couple of thousand feet. There's the beautiful Hudson River, pristine and beautiful like a cup of regular coffee. We're cruising up the Upper West Side, where the play West Side Story was based. All the sharks and jets are still down there. A lot of them are in real estate now. Okay, we're going over the Museum of Natural History right now. That's the start of the parade. They got a life-size blue whale model there, and you can buy smaller blue whales in the gift shop. Coming up on Columbus Circle here, when I first arrived in New York, I danced around and threw my hat in the air like Mary Tyler Moore. She was a lot cuter, though, but who isn't? Now, here you see where Broadway intersects off from Columbus Circle, and the parade will work its way down this way. I used to live in that building at 56. Watch the parade from my bedroom window. The kiddies love that. Look it, there's a billboard for must-see TV's Third Rock from the Sun. You owe me one, Lithgow. Here's Times Square coming up. Spruced up these days. On 42nd Street, you can now buy an inflatable doll and a nice Calvin Klein suit. Now working our way toward Herald Square. This will be the end of our parade route in front of Macy's in all its splendor. They're putting the finishing touches on the logo now. Hey, this is Bill Hartman saying, have a great parade.
Special thanks to Phil Hartman. We're back down on the ground with a popular and very cute film star who's flying high in the Broadway hit, The King and I, Mr. Lou Diamond Phillips. Hey, Lou, how
are you? Happy Thanksgiving. I'm great, Katie, absolutely.
You staying warm?
I'm staying warm. I'm looking at my wives out there getting ready to do their number. And,
your wives.
What'd you say?
All my wives.
Wives?
All the wives and little kitties from Siam.
How do you like playing the King of Siam on Broadway? And is it daunting filling Yul Brynner's shoes?
I don't even try to fill his shoes. I do something a little bit different. I do it my way, and it's a classic role and a classic piece, and Donna Murphy, her second Tony for it, you know. I mean, it is just a treasure that people are rediscovering.
You must love working with the kids.
I love the death. They're great. They all call me King Daddy.
Do you ever need a stand-in? I mean, yours is off the side. Mine's off the top.
We've got the kind of reverse thing going. You know, maybe we could trade. I could give you this and, you know.
I'll work for half price.
You know, Willard, I kind of like this. The King and I are about to watch The King and I. Hmm. The scene is the palace of the King of Siam. It is the very first day of school as we find Mrs. Anna, played by two-time Tony Award winner Donna Murphy, leading the royal wives and children in Getting to Know You.
a very ancient saying, but a true and honest thought, that if you become a teacher, by your pupils you'll be taught.
As a teacher I've been learning, you'll forgive me if I boast, and I've now become an expert on the subject I like most, getting to know. Getting to know all about you. Getting to like you. Getting to hope you like me. Getting to know you. Putting it my way, but nicely. You are precisely my cup of tea. Getting to know you, getting to feel free and easy. When I am with you, getting to know what to say. Haven't you noticed? Suddenly I'm bright and breezy because of all.
And Bullwinkle and the hit musical Rent when Macy's Parade returns live here on NBC.
and welcome back, everybody, to the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. You're watching a portion of the 2 million people lining the streets for this parade, which at this point is at 51st, 52nd Streets and Broadway. And back up here at 77th and Central Park West, you are looking at 400 of America's teens, part of a group, America Sings, and up above them, the Pink Panther balloon provided by Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer Incorporated. He's prepared for a little bit of everything. Well, he's taken off his scarf, but he's got a nice inner tube. This is not the kind of weather you want to be going swimming in, but I guess the Pink Panther can do any of that. There you see America Sings. They'll be performing later in Herald Square. And with me right now, another member of Must See TV, Mr. Jere Burns. He was a swinger on Dear John. He is now an upstanding family man on Something So
Thank
Right
you,
on NBC.
Al. Thank you.
And you are a family guy.
I am a family guy.
Now, you've got your three kids.
They're over there in that crowd of people. Yeah. Freezing. But they ripped their blankets off the hotel beds and they brought them. They're wrapped in them.
Now, when you're here on a parade day like this, what goes through your mind?
I'm glad I'm not in charge. All these guys have been here since like 2 o'clock in the morning.
No, it's rough.
It's amazing. And we actually got here at about 6:30, and there were a lot of people sitting in the stands already.
Well, yeah. I'm going to let you go join your family.
Thanks,
again.
Al.
Something So Right
Happy
on NBC.
Thanksgiving.
You too, Jere Burns.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And here you go.
You're right.
All right. Something So Right. Something So Downtown. Something So
Something
Katie.
So cold.
Something So Cold.
Yes.
Something So Katie and Willard.
All right, Al. Thank you so much. You know, given our schedules, we never get to see enough Broadway shows.
I know. That's one of the few sad things about the shift is you have to go to bed at 6 o'clock at night.
That's right.
I miss Brokaw.
Well, not quite that early, but one show I'm really anxious to see was one that was born off-Broadway, young and full of spirit, the musical Rent, then left home for The Great White Way, where it blossomed as a musical for the 90s. Now this winner of the Tony Award for Best Musical and a Pulitzer Prize comes to Herald Square with its rousing anthem, Seasons of Love. Let's listen to the Broadway cast of Rent.
Yeah.
More parade, more excitement, more holiday spectacle. Come back and celebrate here on NBC.
Welcome back to the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade here on NBC. It is 29 degrees outside. The parade now down in the 40s and making its way toward Herald Square, Broadway and 43rd Street. And making its way up here, we've got the 101 Dalmatians float getting ready to get started to make its way down, provided by Walt Disney Pictures. It is a beautiful day here. I'll tell you, we've had plenty of sunshine. It's been plenty cold. Lots of kids bundled up watching the parade, but I think they're all pretty warm watching all the fun going on. There's Cruella DeVille. Ooh, she's scary, but she's going to be seeing spots before it's all over. I can tell. Look at all those Dalmatians. Wow, I think they're doing the Macarena. I've never seen Dalmatians do the Macarena before, but the kids are having a great time waving, enjoying themselves. And even though it's nice and sunny and cold, you know, the only time it's ever snowed on the parade is in 1989. Before that, it hadn't snowed for 100 years. Let's head on back down to Herald Square and Katie and Willie.
You got it right, Albert, and if you send it, it will come. Macy's has all kinds of jeans, the best in the business, but our favorite jean at Macy's,
Jean McFadden,
of course. We love her. She knows the way, too. Great news, Bullwinkle's making a return for this year's special parade. Oh, boy, I like you. Anyway, no wonder. Did you ever notice what a balloon like Bullwinkle looks like days before the parade? How he gets to be 475 pounds, 68 foot of lovable lug. You just watch your video right now. Yeah.
Boy. Do not step on the balloon, please. Unroll it all the way to the end of the cart.
Okay.
Or until the balloon stops, whichever comes first. Got sets of inflation orders for this, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, Jay, you ready?
Okay, open up. There you go.
There's a separate balloon that attaches right to the top of his head. It's a beanie propeller. It's got 12-volt batteries that tucks into a blind pouch in the balloon. It's the first year that we've ever had a balloon that automatically animated. So down the route, this propeller is going to be spinning around on his head. The propeller goes up first, the antlers, then Bullwinkle's head, the arms and hands, then Rocky's body and head, Rocky's tail, the parachute, Bullwinkle's body, then his waist and hips, and his legs and feet.
It's going to be a lot of fun. Take a rubber band.
Always put two. Always. You got to make sure you're covered if one of them breaks. And you're golden.
That'll give you some idea of the enormous work that goes into putting on this yearly Macy's Spectacular. And speaking of spectaculars, we got one uptown.
He's Al, making a spectacle of himself.
I didn't want
Willard?
To say that because
I know.
He's my friend.
You were being nice.
Not always, but Al, who? Carol.
Thanks, Willard. Thanks, Kitty. You're looking at Harold the Fireman. He's a throwback to the 40s when they originally had a Harold the Fireman. They have recreated him and brought him back. In fact, back in the 40s, at the end of the parade, they used to release the balloons, and people would find them and mail them back. Well, Harold is back, and much to the delight of a lot of the kids in the crowd, and some of the bigger kids, too, all seeming to have a really good time enjoying a guy like Harold. Oh, hey, Harold, where are you going so fast? Where's the fire, pal? As he heads to Central Park West. I'll tell you, and there's the wonderful Spider-Man all the way back down there. You can see he's trying to make his way down, too. That was a real humdinger of a time. Hey, that's it for me up here. I'm going to be jumping in the car and joining Katie and Willard down at Herald Square. Now, let's have more coverage of the parade right after this, Don Pardo.
Don't make a move. They've got all the right ones. The world-famous Radio City Music Hall Rockettes. When we return to the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade here on NBC.
Welcome back, everybody. Hope you're enjoying the parade from a nice, warm, and cozy spot. Out here in Herald Square, the temperature is 31 degrees. And even though our feet may be cold, down on Broadway, we've got 60 of the hottest legs in town.
Oh, boy, they're my favorites. I can't get close enough. Hold me closer. Performing a number from their sensational Radio City Christmas Spectacular. Hear the world-famous Radio City Rockettes.
And floats, bands, and your favorite stars. The Macy's Thanksgiving Parade arrives at Herald Square when we return. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the moment is here. Now entering Herald Square for the 70th year celebration, the 1996 Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
Those sirens, Katie, can only mean one thing. Our boys in blue are revving up again this year. The New York City Police Department, New York City's finest, the Motorcycle Brigade.
Willard, can there be a bigger party than this? Clowns, confetti, the traditional Macy's star balloon. And there's Chloe, or she'll be coming soon, the holiday clown, who symbolizes the proud artistic tradition of clowning around in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
You know, I love of clowns always have had a special affection. And the sound of music we hear is the band from Southwest Missouri State University under the direction of Jerry Hoover. They're making their second appearance in Macy's Parade, and we're told that they represent the largest musical group playing today. Take it away, Missouri. I can wish her a happy 100th birthday.
She's an amazing lady. We congratulate her. Wasn't the Pride marching band terrific, Willard? And look at his feel of the beat. Flapping his wings, rolling his eyes, and bobbing his head. Can we talk turkey? It's Turkey Float's 25th Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
I like turkey. Give me your wings. This year, Tom ditched up with a family with a whole lot of food. The Diddley. And they're trucking on down the street to the main Diddley, rock and roll with Bo. Let's listen to the man himself confessing Bo Diddley is crazy.
I want to be. I said I want to play my rock and roll music and make people happy. Mother jumped up and shook her head, and this is what the lady said. Are you sick?
Sick.
Are you a lunatic?
Lunatic.
Are you sick?
Sick.
Are you a lunatic?
Lunatic.
All I want to do is play my music and make people happy. I didn't want to be an old drunk like my pappy. All I want to do is make people jump up and down. Do they thing and make them jump and spin around.
It's a bird. It's a plane. Now, wait a minute. Would you believe a spinning percutter beating cap is perched between the antlers of the beloved Bullwinkle Hoot? And what a thrill it is to welcome him back to our parade. And for the first time ever, with his pal Rocky the Flying Squirrel. Now, that's what I call a dynamic duo.
And famous, too, Willard, Jay Ward's Rocky and Bullwinkle are provided by Universal Studios Consumer Products Group. At 68 feet in length, Willard, even his arch enemies, Boris and Natasha, would be impressed with this Bullwinkle.
Get that squirrel off my back, kitty. Bullwinkle has been called the finest example of the North American quad. As Rocky says, Bullwinkle has more brains in his little finger than he has in his whole head. Think about that, friends.
Here's the fun part.
the Lawrence brothers, Joey, Matthew, and Andy, plus everybody's favorite feline, Garfield the Cat, when our parade continues here on NBC.
It's 85 degrees in downtown Manhattan on this most unusual day.
In our dreams, Willard, in our dreams.
It's a little bit cool but nice. The Pilgrim man and woman, how sweet they are. Beautiful symbol of America, and of course, Thanksgiving. Been on this now 375 years. Thanking the good Lord for all the good things in life.
Meanwhile, down by the riverside, drums signal the arrival of the Indian canoe, Soaring Spirit. The float is a celebration of Native American art and culture. In addition to the gorgeous traditional Indian designs, the boat rows gently down the stream with some familiar and enduring passengers, Pocahontas, Davy Crockett, and the glamorous star of NBC's daytime drama, Days of Our Lives, Deidre Hall.
I like her. Deidre's been a star for a long time. Everybody loves her. Like all the bands, get this, the Science Hill High School group worked hard for the money to pay for their trip expenses. In one day, this Johnson City, Tennessee band washed over 1,400 cars and wound up with a brand new band room, new uniforms, and a very clean set of fingernails.
Making their first appearance in Macy's parade, they are officially on the town in New York, New York. Compliments of Leonard Bernstein. Bands here today hold some kind of fundraiser to get themselves to New York. Silent auctions, car washes, as we mentioned, bake sales, and then if there's extra cash, they'll see a Broadway show, visit the Empire State Building, or take a cruise around Manhattan.
And Katie and I got this job. We washed all the windows in the Empire State Building. That's why we're here. Here is my kind of cruise, a banana split boat with three different flavors of clowns. This is the most fattening parade I've ever worked in my life.
Willard, we've seen a float and a balloon. Now here comes a combination. This year's first balloon. Chocolate colorworks provided by M&M's chocolate candy.
How sweet it is.
Even deeper than love. If
Willard. Hey, Willard.
Yes, ma'am.
Guess who I see floating down the street? Here's a hint. He's fat, kind of lazy, and has a major attitude.
That sounds like my agent. I didn't know he was going to be in this parade, Jake.
Down, boy, Willard. It's America's favorite fat cat, Garfield. Garfield may like his catnip and his catnap, but he's managed to be a part of the parade festivity since 1984. He's provided, incidentally, by Paws Incorporated.
You got that right. And we're told that Garfield's birth weight was 5 pounds, 6 ounces. That's a big cat. But today it takes 15 Macy's volunteers to handle this 400-pound ice cream-craving, lasagna-loving feline who eats until he's, do I dare say it, cat-a-tonic?
Arr!
Good show, Walter. Willard.
The residents of Sesame Street, the Big Bird Balloon, and gold medalist Oksana Bayou, when the 1996 Macy's Parade marches on, here on NBC. NBC's telecast of Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade is sponsored in part by the Braun Oral-B Plaque Remover. Dentists recommend changing your toothbrush every 3 months. We suggest you change it forever.
The years strutting their stuff down Broadway. Welcome back, everybody. We're enjoying the first parade appearance of the Holiday Clowns. It's a fun day, and they have a colorful way of expressing our sentiment. Best wishes for a happy Thanksgiving Day.
Meanwhile, Willard, it looks like school's in session over on the Sesame Street float.
La, 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 la. That's Bert and Ernie, Cookie Monster, and the big man on campus, the one and only Bird, all provided by Children's Theater Television Workshop.
And once again this year, hanging at Hooper Store and the Furry Arms Hotel is the all-star group of Muppets and cast members, among them Sesame Street regular Ruth Buzzy. Let's listen as they sing a little bit.
Muppets and how we miss Jim Henson. What a beautiful, sweet, beautiful man. But if you think Big Bird, the Muppets a big deal, feast your eyes on Big Bird Balloon Fella. Provided by Jim Henson Productions. He's 8 times taller and 10 times wider than his fine feathered counterpart, and he's celebrating his 9th appearance in this Macy's parade.
That's right, and Big Bird once gave me a feather off his tail, Willard. I was so honored. And what's nice is that Big Bird is now teaching children whose parents learned their ABCs right on Sesame Street.
And understand that just last month, Russia joined with the Children's Television Workshop, and now that country's children and their parents can enjoy what millions of children all over the world have been able to do for the last 3 decades.
Thank goodness for CTW providing consistently high-quality programs for our little ones. goodness Big Bird wore a sweater this morning, huh, Willard? It's chilly out here.
Like a cold bird.
Meanwhile, the magical world of Mother Goose Balloon is a signature piece in a parade that's indeed about magic and miracles and daring to dream.
And, of course, Humpty Dumpty's swaying on the wall. Let's check him out. He's beautiful. He's truly my kind of guy. I mean, you just check him out. Little Boy Blue catching some Z's by a babbling brook. It is sweet. They're all dancing and singing. That's nice. Hi, Humpty, don't fall.
On the bridge, the lovely lady herself, Mother Goose, and by her side, Oksana Bayul, who won our hearts and an Olympic gold medal at Lillehammer as the best skater in the world. She's a new American citizen, Willard, and this has got to be a special day of thanks for Oksana Bayul.
Welcome, welcome indeed. Surrounding this whole magical world, La Danse School of Ballet.
I love when you speak French.
Oh, mais c'est toi, qu'est-ce que c'est là? Boum, boum.
Still to come, those fabled females, Vanessa Williams, Shirley Jones, and Alice in Wonderland, live here on NBC.
New York's finest hour, Katie. They love it. This is their show, their parade, and how sweet it is.
And the race is on, Willard. Well, who's your money on, the tortoise or the hare?
Oh, I got to go along with the tortoise. I ain't had too much luck with hare over the years, darling.
Thank you, Shaggy Scott. New to our parade from England is Albert and Friends Instant Circus.
I love circuses. And these kids, ranging in age from 12 to 16, make it look so easy. But get this, balancing on those stilts and those unicycles is a really hard-won skill.
Watching over all the merriment is Wiggle Worm. He's inching his way into Herald Square for the fourth year, a parade favorite, all 50 fun-filled feet of him.
Worming his way into your heart. And speaking of fun-filled, looks like the A-list tea party's on, a royal card game in the Alice in Wonderland float. That'll be along in a minute. You'll see. That's still Wiggle Worm. Every once in a while, I do something wonderful, like look at the monitor.
There we go. Having tea with Alice is the Mad Hatter and the Dormouse. And lots of people in the stands as well. There we go.
That's a nice ad-lib, Katie. Up in the rose bush. Can I go now? Up in the rose bush, that boisterous Queen of Hearts and one of our favorite jokers, Aileen Boozler. Check it out.
And do we hear some music in the distance? We do, Willard. Striking up the band is Cypress High School from California. The 181-member group performs a medley of cartoon classics under the direction of Darlene Hale.
Thank you.
sounds fantastic, huh? You like that?
They really are great.
And I'm glad we hear the music, Katie. Those kids have won an incredible 270 trophies in the past 10 years. And now this show band has a new honor, the Macy's Thanksgiving Parade.
They're really a talented group, Willard. Now it's time for our march hare. And he's marching to the beat of his own drum. Here comes the Nestle Quick Bunny.
Hey, old Quick Bunny may be quick, Katie, but at 520 pounds, he's the second heaviest balloon in this parade. Did you know that, Katie?
I didn't know that.
Well, if you'd have read the script at rehearsal, you'd have known that. But this 40 Macy's handlers can take care of him. He ain't heavy, he's our bunny. Hey, this fabulous balloon is provided by, guess who? Nestle Beverage Company.
What a surprise. Willard, Quick Bunny would need a high-rise hutch. 7 stories tall and in the Big Apple. That's a lot of lettuce.
That's no dumb bunny, Katie. As Quick Bunny turns the corner, 34th Street comes into view, and the view from here is splendid. And that's thanks to the 34th Street Partnership, a local group adding just another beauty mark on the face of this spectacular city. You want to come up and see what they're doing here at Times Square? Have you seen what? It's almost finished. It is terrific.
And Quick Bunny is very lucky because the wind is relatively calm this morning. Willie, we've done other parades where the wind is kicked up, and these sizable balloons go here, there, and everywhere.
Don't go away, still a march, Lea Thompson and Kenny Rogers. And we'll enter the world of Willy Wonka with Liz Torres when we come back.
You know, I got to tell you, my 3 dogs at home, this is their favorite part of the entire parade. Every dog they say may have his day, but this year, this Thanksgiving Day belongs to Toby, the parade dog.
Willard, it looks like somebody's taught this old dog some new tricks. Toby wiggles her ears, and she blinks her eyes, too.
Well, I can do that if I work at it. Toby is a real looker. That's thanks to some great grooming by Manfred Bass, the greatest guy in the business of putting balloons and floats together, the master builder and designer of all the wonderful Macy's floats. He and his crew worked their magic at the Artisan Studio in Hoboken, New Jersey.
Willard, I guess you could say it's a dog-meet-dog world this Thanksgiving. Toby, meet Clifford, the big red dog. Clifford has many best friends. His very best, though, is his owner, Emily Elizabeth, who keeps Clifford on his 65-foot-long leash.
That's the way Mary takes care of me.
She keeps you on a shorter one, doesn't she, Willard?
That's my agent. Katie, there are nearly 50 million Clifford books in print. Did you know that? I didn't know that. And as many of his fans already know, that real Clifford is the same size as the 60-foot balloon passing in parade.
Clifford is provided by Scholastic Incorporated, and strolling with Emily Elizabeth are 50 of New York's most dashing dog walkers, all Macy's employees.
Hey, you know, Katie, this parade makes me feel like a kid in a candy store, doesn't it?
Absolutely, positively, Willard.
And I shouldn't be doing that because I'm trying to keep it down. Now, the wonder of all of this comes to light in the pure imaginational float provided by Fujifilm of USA Incorporated.
This float celebrates the 25th anniversary home video release of one of my favorite movies, Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, as the John Larroquette show's Liz Torres takes us on a flight of pure imagination.
I love her. I love her.
Come with me and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look and you'll see into your imagination. We'll begin with a spin, traveling in a world of my creation. What we'll see will defy explanation.
Change the world, becoming new. Let it grow, life by now, to compare with me.
more floats, balloons, and clowns. And the Jolly Polly Pirate Ship finds treasure on Broadway, the cast of Cats. Don't miss it.
Big ones here in Manhattan. Look at those pretty pictures. I mean, the city never, it's a gorgeous day and the wind's not blowing. And welcome back, everybody. We're so glad you could join us on this nippy November morning.
What's it, 29 degrees, right, Willard?
Yeah, 29 degrees after 7. Yeah.
But we've got our love to keep us warm or something like that. Trust anyway, me. It took some supportive Sarasotans to get the Riverview High School band here today. The Florida kids lost their deposit when an airline went belly up, but the community came through with the money.
Hallelujah.
McDonald's dress tartan, aren't they? Who'd want? Riverview High School's wonderful uniforms, incidentally, are authentic, the real thing, and so are the terrific Pipers. Talk about the real thing. When it comes to grace and beauty, you can write this name across the sky. She flutters down Broadway with the wind beneath her wings. Who is she?
Who is she?
Sky dancer, of course.
No kidding. Ah, yes, a pretty girl is like a melody, and blowing in the wind might be just the magical tune for Skydancer, provided by Average Gentilly Entertainment Incorporated. She's pretty in pink and purple, and she's back to add sparkle to the parade for her second year.
Willard, how'd you like to take a spin around the dance floor with her?
I won't float, don't ask me.
Well, with a wingspan of 34 feet, there certainly could be no doubt who would lead. What's this? Lobster on Turkey Day?
Wait a minute. Something's not right.
Rocky Lobster's smiling like he's about to order a person by the pound, and his passengers, Popeye, that studly, manly sailor man, and his significant other, Olive Oil.
Ahoy there, matey. I am what I am. Wait till you see what's after Popeye and Olive Oil as they move their lobster just around the corner. They're passing by right now, even as we speak. And look, who's here? My idol, Carmen Miranda, Quantenigo, bigger than life musical movie star recreated by our colorful clown captain, Shannon Murphy, along with her luscious parading pineapples.
You did a Carmen Miranda impersonation one day, didn't you?
I think NBC's trying to forget it, but yes.
Among Macy's recreations this year is Flying Fish, who first came down the parade pike in 1941. He's 30 feet long, and we're sure glad this big one didn't get away. He's one happy halibut, Willard.
Are we going to do that routine, or are we going to forget it?
Oh, the part where he's not floundering?
You give me a headache, don't you?
You're making me eel. Ahoy, me mateys.
That's my line. Ahoy, me mateys. It's the Jolly Polly Pirate Ship, and manning the colorful confetti cannons, some of the coolest cats on the high seas.
Willard, since its maiden voyage in England 15 years ago, Cats has been a treasure scene worldwide, from Australia to Finland to the Pirates of Pittsburgh.
Pirates of Penzance, I think. It's soon to be the longest-running show in Broadway history, so its motto was certainly a prophetic one, Cats now and forever.
Pink Panther goes in search of Caroline in the city. Lea Thompson, that is. When Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade continues here on NBC.
Oh boy, do we love our parade. It gets better every year in New York City's finest. And on with the parade celebration. 70 years. You've done it for 5. I've done it for 10. How sweet it is, Katie.
And we have so much fun every single year. And I think we're getting better and better at it, Willard.
One of these days we'll get it right, but not today. Marching on their 40th anniversary is Alabama Jacksonville State University Band. Bringing us the Broadway classic, Don't Rain on My Parade. Hit it.
Don't rain on our parade. Don't snow on it either, right, Willard?
Only one time, I believe, I remember it snowed on our parade. 89.
That's right. It hadn't snowed for 100 years before that, which really surprised me, Willard.
We've been very lucky. This is a gorgeous day.
Meanwhile, unpack your wetsuit because we're about to journey 20,000 leagues under the sea. It's the Sea Venture Balloon, and it features a fantastical submarine confronted by a 24-foot-tall cold air inflatable octopus.
Katie, listen quietly now. I don't want to speak too loud. That octopus is in a league all his own. His 8 tentacles are 30 feet long. And from his facial expression, he doesn't seem to be singing, "Embrace me, my sweet embrace."
Taking the nautical journey is NBC star Lea Thompson, who usually has her adventures as Caroline in the City, of course.
It's hot pink, but the coolest of the cool. It's that Hollywood hepcat, the Pink Panther, my personal idol. Enjoying the high life as he floats down Broadway for his 9th Macy's Parade. Pink's balloon is provided by Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer Incorporated. He's about to lose his shorts.
And what a life he lives. An eligible bachelor catting around Hollywood, chauffeured by the rich and famous, of course. He himself happens to be the length of 3 stretch limos. When Pink won his Oscar, I'm sure he thanked his producer, director Blake Edwards, composer Henry Mancini, his creator and animation legend, Fritz Freleng.
There's a real act that came together. The music and the Panther, what a combination. Katie, when you're a jet setter like we are, and the Pink Panther, you're all set for all kind of climates. He's sporting a muffler and scarf for our November parade, and a 40-foot-wide inner tube, just in case his shorts drop, for that last-minute invite to Boca Raton.
I hope he takes me with him. He's hip, Willard. He even has a press agent who, by the way, informs us that unlike most felines, Pink can pick up things with his tail, which has a reach of 66 feet.
I could go that way. Hundred of America's best have banded together to form America Sings. When these bright teens are not performing as a group or singing in their school charities, they're out helping underprivileged kids. So let's listen to the best and the brightest under the direction of John Jacobson with Every Time the Music Starts.
When the Macy's parade continues, Katie and Willard introduce Miss America 1997, also the Betty Boop balloon. And later on, don't forget the jolly old man. He's coming to town.
We're back Thanksgiving Day 1996 live right here on NBC. And we're in full holiday swing. We hope the same is true at your house. Here come a bunch of clowns, Willard, who should stick around for the Easter parade. We'll be seeing them momentarily, won't we, Willard?
I just saw them on the monitor. Don't the folks at home, don't you see those clowns? Anyway, they're great. I think they're spectacular. You know I love clowns ever since Bozo. Larry Hartman, if you're watching, we love you.
And I hope all the 45 million people who are watching us at home are having a good Thanksgiving morning so far and are warm and cozy in the comfort of their living rooms or
bedrooms. Thank God for your
bedrooms.
Health, your country, a little food, and all your family can't beat it. That's what this parade's all about. That's why it's America's number one parade. New York City comes alive. Just goes absolutely wild. Everybody's a kid again in New York for this parade. Macy's costume people, I think, sort of outdid themselves. What a 70th celebration this is.
Now, you know, all we need, Willard, is a great big cake. Ask and ye shall receive. Feast your eyes on the brand new Party Time Float provided by Hanes Hosiery.
Tara Holland is the guest of honor, and her mission as Miss America 1997. Her mission is to promote literacy in the 50 states. So let's join the party as Long Island's Valley Streamers dance team strut their stuff, and Tara sings to us about the best of times.
Live and love as hard as you know how, and make this moment
pretty.
I mean, that is one pretty woman.
The pulse of the Macy's Parade is in the hearts of our band kids who work their way to the Big Apple. To many, it's the ultimate band experience. Right now, let the drums roll out, let the trumpet call, let the cymbals ring. It's time for director Charles Casavant and his group from Indiana University of Pennsylvania to strike up the band.
Sometimes I'm wrong, but I think Indiana, Pennsylvania is the hometown of Jimmy Stewart.
I think you're right, Willard.
Got a statue and everything. Anyway, as you know, Katie, every band has a volunteer captain to make sure that the kids have a good time when they visit the Big Apple. Macy's Janet Slaby, beautiful, just wonderful lady. She is commandeered this party.
And we should salute all the Macy's volunteers who have done so much to make this parade possible every year. 4,000 of them from 47 stores here in the Northeast.
They really get into it.
Meanwhile, have I got a girl for you, Mr. Scott. Before there was Marilyn and Madonna, cartoonist Max Fleischer created the glamour gal who starred in more than 100 cartoons. Betty Boop, provided today by King Features.
I like all those cute little kids, but I'm gaga over Betty. You know, Betty was the first animated sex symbol, and at age 66, take a look, she's still a doll, inflatable or otherwise. And we're told that Miss Boop is still single. Then again, what working stiff could come up with an engagement ring 12 feet in diameter? Actually, get this, Kitty. Well, stay with me then. If Betty Boop married C. Everett Koop, her name would be Betty Boop Koop. I'd rather make it a sitcom out of that.
But meanwhile, our sassy sirens garter uses enough material to make garters for all 30 Radio City Rockettes and Dennis Rodman.
An Olympic hero meets, a superhero meets 101 Dalmatians. You'll meet all of them and more when the fun continues here on NBC.
That's
Baby
beginning.
Elephant,
that's my
right?
Song, yeah. I was going to say it's beginning to look like a lot like Thanksgiving. Disney's 101 Dalmatians opened nationwide yesterday, Katie. And take it from me, the reviews were not spotty. Get that? We didn't even have to change the paper. It's an unqualified hit, and you can read about it in black and white.
Right now, those classic movie favorites are coming to life right here at Herald Square. The float is provided by Walt Disney Pictures, bringing us the song Cruella de Vil is the evil lady herself, along with her henchmen, canines Pongo and Purdy, and 99 perfectly healthy puppies, I mean kids, sporting Dalmatian spots.
Cruella de Vil, if she doesn't scare you, no evil thing will. To see her, you have to take a sudden chill. Cruella, Cruella de Vil. Inhuman beast, she ought to be locked up and never released. The world was such a wholesome place to deal. Cruella, Cruella de Vil. thing will. He's like a spider waiting for the kill. Look out for Cruella to feel. At first you think Cruella is the devil. After time is more way to shine. You come to realize you've seen her kind of eye watching you from under a rock. Was such a wholesome place until Cruella to feel. So evil even a has to face. Let's face it, a place like us could really ruin your whole day.
Cruella DeVille, the woman we love to hate.
I like, don't you like villains? I don't ever want to be one, but I like villains.
I tell you what, I liked her sexy red patent leather boots.
I liked it when she did that dance. I thought for a minute we were going to lose our license. The parade really is heating up now. I smell smoke, Katie. In fact, it looks like somebody put out a call to the Funny Firefighter Brigade. Check it out.
These guys are great, and more Little Dalmatians, but they aren't from Disney's movie. They're actually working fire pups. Willard, to celebrate their anniversary, Macy's has recreated an old-style balloon. I'm not talking about you, Willard. This is a vintage photo from the early 1940s of Harold the fireman. Well, like his role model, the all-new Harold is ready for action. And like his cartoon ancestors, the 1996 Harold the fireman only has four fingers. But with a volume of 2,500 cubic feet of helium and a height of 32 feet tall, our hero could blow out any high-rise fire.
That's what I call a firefighter, Katie. Macy's tells us that prior to his debut as a fireman in the 40s, and I remember that, believe it or not, Harold made his way down Broadway as a policeman and another year as a baseball player. Guy's got a problem. He doesn't know who he is. Anyway, somebody's got to do a scouting report for Joe just to check out and see what a super guy he is.
He's multi-talented. Willard, it's always an occasion when a band makes its debut with the Macy's Parade. I'm sure everybody back in Bellbrook, Ohio is proud of the Marching Eagles from Bellbrook High under the direction of David Spitzer. Here they are with Stars and Stripes Forever. Americana, Willard, and what better holiday to salute the old red, white, and blue.
And I keep watching it back here. I got to pay attention up here. This is the one, Catherine, and carry on the patriotic spirit. Two of America's founding fathers, George Washington, Benjamin Franklin, and where's Jack Welch? He should be in there.
Even the clowns are doing a little flag waving today, Willard, and doing a little crowd waving is clown captain Paula Spinoza. Mm-hmm.
Uncle Sam. Good old Uncle Sam, head and shoulders above all the rest. We have Canton, Ohio to thank for the Jazz Doll Twirlers. Now, they are truly amazing. Get this, the age range from somewhere between 70 girls, from preschoolers to college ladies. And it's really pretty easy to see why this team has won the Grand National Twirling Championship. I can balance a spoon on my nose, but that's about it. Look at that. Terrific.
Washington and Franklin, stars and stripes forever, flag-waving clowns and 70 twirlers? Well, here's the lady who can do it every time. Making the ultimate patriotic statement is the Statue of Liberty float provided by GMC.
And this is what you call, I mean, just pulling out all the stops, Katie. Lady Liberty, 10 Uncle Sams, and another very awesome lady. Our own fantastic Olympic gymnast, Dominique Dawes.
Hailing from Baltimore, Maryland, Willard.
I didn't know that Palmer. She a Palmer girl?
She is so cute. She did a great job in Atlanta. We certainly have no shortage of heroes this year, Willard. Dominique Dawes, Oksana Bayul, and of course, our world champion, New York Yankees.
And they're still just a couple of blocks away, just north of here, and I can't wait till they hit Herald Square. Love those Yankees.
Willard, the parade also has an official superhero always weaving a web of adventure. It's Spider-Man himself, provided by Marvel Entertainment Group, Incorporated.
And you know, the story, Katie, Spider-Man started really out as a college student, and he was a photographer, Peter Parker. But just a little bit of radiation activity, Spider-Man gave him the power to scale walls and sling webs from his wrists. And Spider-Man can get an awful lot of bad guys in that 40 by 36 foot web.
I'll say, Willard, I could see where a damsel in distress might be wowed by this pumped up superhero.
Thank
you. What a physique. At 78 feet, he's also the longest balloon in this whole parade.
Oh, boy. He makes me want to hear a commercial like this.
Macy's Day Parade, when we return live here on NBC.
Howdy, partners, and welcome to our Western salute with the Cactus Clowns and a whole rip-roaring, snorting, tooting, wooden rodeo from Arkansas and Tennessee, kicking up a good old-fashioned fuss, the Red River Rocky Top Flogger.
I used to play the violin, now I fiddle away.
Willard, that horse-drawn buckboard is hauling a trio of ladies from the off-Broadway musical Cowgirls.
We never milked cows
or rode bulls
or birthed a calf
or called a man my better half.
But we're cowgirls, we're the spirit of this land. We're free to be a country classical band.
The Westward Ho Float with the award-winning Tucson, Arizona Boys Chorus with Thank God I'm a Country Boy.
And the work's all done in the sunset.
Oh, fantastic. Thank God I'm a country boy. And from deep in the heart of Texas, friends, I mean way down in Texas, a Lone Star medley from the Cisco Wrangler Band and Bells under the direction of Kyle Virtel. And these Cisco kids can't claim a certain Western character as a sort of a homeboy, but their Texas town of 3800 claimed them as one notoriously fine show band. Check them out. Cisco Wrangler Band, nothing but fantastic. Katie, my love, the answer is he's older than the Old West and the Old East, the North and the South combined, and very lovable. Who is it?
It's coming to me, Willard.
Get it.
Who is Barney?
You got a $10 and a box of Snickers, and Alex Trebek would be very proud of that. Well, it is Barney.
Was it the Daily Double?
You got it. It's no surprise to find him on Thanksgiving with his best buckaroo, Baby Boppin' BJ.
Willard, Barney is big. I'm talking big. He's not your garden variety superstar. We're talking Megasaurus. And now the so-called Elvis of the preschool set has entered the parade as a balloon provided by Lyric Studios. Barney joined us for the first time back in 1994. That would put it at his age at what? I think 200 million and three?
I could do a special on him.
Salutes Hollywood, from the silence to that devilish Woody Woodpecker and that gorgeous Shirley Jones. Party on when the Macy's Parade continues live on NBC. NBC's telecast of Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade is being sponsored in part by Otten Incorporated, who wishes you and your family peace and joy in the holiday season. Otten, the fabric of our lives.
Oh, we're back, and I mean, it's lovely. About 30 degrees, the wind is not much at all, and the sun is out. How sweet for the 70th. Welcome back to our salute to the silence. Crazy Keystone Cops, a not-so-silent film crew, and with a huge puff like that, I mean, friends, I'm all set for close-ups.
And Willard, aboard the rocket car, the cast of the off-Broadway musical, The Coconuts. These guys would get high marks from the brothers, Mark.
Yeah. Making their Macy's Parade debut, the Owen Valley Patriot Band, the Guard, under the direction of Peter Kikta. And these Spencer, Indiana kids hit just the right note as they march into the entertainment capital. So there's no business like show business. We'll be right back.
like curling up in front of the television and watching an old movie classic, is there?
You got a nice black and white movie and some milk and cookies, a roaring fire. I'm hooked.
Well, unfortunately, Willard, half of the films made before 1950 have literally disintegrated. Today, we thank American Movie Classics for their campaign in helping to preserve Hollywood's film heritage. AMC provides the Hollywood Salute Float and the channel's popular hosts, Bob Dorian and Nick Clooney. Right now, movie legend and one of my all-time favorites, Shirley Jones, revisits Oklahoma with Oh, What a Beautiful Morning.
Too, Catherine. 35 balloon handlers mimic our 75-foot-tall bird in their Woody look-alike costumes. Woody has an arm span of 45 feet and just happens to be senior balloon of this year's parade. Been around longer than any of them.
Come on, Willard, you have to do it. It's tradition. Woody's impeccable laugh.
Are you ready for this?
Give it a try. Should have wormed your way out of it, Willard. Now let's hear it from the gang in the booth, shall we?
I thought mine sounded more authentic, if you know the truth.
There's always next year, Willard.
More Macy's Parade coming up right here on NBC.
It's still about 29 degrees, but the wind's picked up a little. It feels a little colder here, but Herald Square has got the body heat. The award-winning Universal Fabulous Cheer and Dance Association's Captains of America.
Provided by Mike Miller and Associates, they salute the sport of football with a 150-member team, 150 referees, and 500 cheerleaders, all choreographed by Jimmy Sanford and Carrie Quartaro.
Take it away.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Go!
could get some of that energy, they might renew my contract. Yeah, if I had to guess, I would think you were a cheerleader in school.
What made you say that, Willard?
I don't know where I am. I think I lost my place. Anyway, that's terrific, Katie. Anyway, that's all I got to say about that. I'll tell you, things are happening all over town.
And in any case, you know what, Willard? Everyone knows you can't have the big game without a pep rally and stirring things up for 10 more UCA cheerleaders taking the rah-rah ride on the pep rally float. And this year's special parade is definitely something to cheer about.
Let's pick up that crowd.
He's faster than the speed of sound. That's why they call him Sonic 3D Blast. Deal with it. He is the coolest. But when it comes to video game characters, dude, he's the hottest. Sonic is provided by Sega of America Incorporated, dude.
Hey, dude. Hey, Katie, let me tell you something. He is one Hartman hedgehog. Ding DeRose is spiky quills down his back. All boosted up for today's parade, did you say?
As if. I'd say he's dropping some serious tune.
Dude! Oh, that's your line. You lost me, Katie. I don't even know where we are.
To say our totally tall hedgehog high on helium would be an understatement. To bring his 64 by 26 foot frame to life, Sonic is fed nearly 19,000 cubic feet of helium, more than any other balloon in this parade.
All right, now it's time for that feel-good sound of the New York Police Department's marching band. And it really feels good to see them marching instead of towing my car away. Here they are, New York's finest, never better, the NYPD marching band. They are the best. And celebrating New York as an entertainment and sports capital is the Big Apple Float. It's provided by the New York Daily News, my favorite paper. Maybe I'll mention my name. And it's no surprise who's grabbing the headlines this year. In all their glory, the world champion New York Yankees.
Avid baseball fan or not, Willard, everyone was dazzled by the Bronx Bombers' stunning come-from-behind victory in the World Series against the Atlanta Braves. Right now, Tory's heroes are hitting home runs with parade watchers. Derek Jeter, Yankee shortstop, and rookie of the year among them. Who else is around, Willard?
You just check him out. You may not see him in the order, but check out Wayne Box. He's there. And Marino Duncan is there. Andy Fox is there. Charlie Hayes is there. He's third baseman who caught that foul ball for the final out. And on, Tino Martinez and Jim Mache. Jeff Nelson, outfielder Paul O'Neill, Dave Pavlik, and Bernie Williams. They're all there, the best.
Along with coaches Tony Cloninger and Jose Cardinal and announcers Michael Kay and John Sterling.
Clowns clowning, Vanessa Williams singing, Peter Rabbit hopping. Much more parade live here on NBC.
Welcome back, everybody. 2 years ago, everyone at this parade was deeply touched by the appearance of children around the world, a signing group of 30 youngsters from Maryland. And happily, they're back.
That's right, Katie, and our kids are aboard United World, a float celebrating the spirit of unity with a bridge connecting the continents, and it's provided by United Airlines.
Right now, children around the world, under the direction of Kelly Caruso, join Vanessa Williams, who captures the mood of this season with I'll Be Home for Christmas.
Love light, please.
favorite Christmas songs. It's on Vanessa's new album, Star Bright. And, Willard, the Haverettes Girls Marching Band from England is here. They needed a show-stopping idea for a fundraiser in order to get here. So what did they do?
What did they do?
They shaved their band director's head in front of the whole town.
I laughed when I heard that. Let's listen as the girls, under the direction of the formerly bald Jeff Brown, do the Lambeth Walk. Hit it, gang.
Southern Bells, and our 50 Azalea Trail Maids from Alabama are absolutely dazzling in their colorful gowns from the antebellum period.
Well, bless my soul and grab my grits. They've come north for their third parade, Katie, and they're a sight to behold. Ah, ladies, good afternoon.
Willard, our second new balloon is heading this way. He's hopping off the pages of Beatrix Potter's classic, The Tale of Peter Rabbit, just in time to help celebrate Macy's 70th annual parade. And he's provided by publisher Frederick Warren and Company.
Ah, that mischievous little bunny is a household name, although a name certain Mr. McGregor would rather forget. Heavy drama here. But at 60 feet long, 22 feet wide, and 400 pounds, this Peter Rabbit would be a match for any Mr. McGregor's that he might ever run into along the garden path.
The Jolly One's almost here, but we've still got more treats and sweets. The Cat in the Hat, the Captain and Tennille, and Sherry Lewis and Lamb Chop. March on back here.
We're back, and there's a rocking horse that would light up any child's eyes. And catering to the kid in all of us is the Holiday Sweets Float, featuring a donut shop made out of candy and cookies, my kind of bakery. And it's all provided by Time to Make the Dunkin' Donuts.
Hey, where's Fred? Is he down there? Fred, I love Fred. Watching those there. Hey, Freddy boy. Watching those delectable donuts roll off the assembly line. Fred the Baker, 20 Macy's Thea Star winners, plus two people who've been stars for 20 years. They've also been married for 20 years. Their secret?
Muskrat love?
No, they eat Dunkin' Donuts. No, Captain and Tennille. And their award Grammy-winning mega hit, Love, will keep us together.
Thank you.
Unbelievable. Fantastic. I think Roker just broke his back. Anyway, this seems to be the year for anniversaries. And celebrating his 40th, the Dr. Seuss superstar, the Cat in the Hat, and Esprit provides this fabulous balloon.
Is it true? What did you say? The Cat in the Hat is 40 today?
Ah, that's right, my dear. It's true. It's true. The Cat in the Hat is as old as you.
But wait, hold on. You're wrong, I fear. I won't turn 40 until next year. But thanks for telling the world, my dear.
Have no fear. I've got to get out of here. Hey, sorry about that. Hey, isn't he the cat meow? I mean, with his umbrella, 16 foot wide, bow tie. And when he goes to a meeting at his publisher's cat famous chapeau, his two floors. High, but that's another story. Story.
I get it.
Shoot the writer. Anyway. Writer's half shot now. Anyway. So long, Kit Kat. 1985, their performance in President Reagan's inaugural parade was canceled because of 20 below zero weather. But today, under C. Philip McIntyre's direction, these James F. Burns high schoolers are blowing loud and clear. Let's listen to the South Carolina state champs wailing on Broadway.
Is that holiday feeling getting stronger, though?
It's getting stronger, darling.
It is for me, and I think it has more than a little to do with what's going on out there. Look what's chugging down Broadway, direct from the North Pole. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, the Santa Land Express, and it's right on schedule.
And you know who's right behind them. I mean, aboard this 45-foot authentic steam locomotive is the Junior Gilders Chorus, the best from Lucille Ball Theater in Jamestown, New York, her hometown, I might add.
The chorus teams up with Macy's parade legend Sherry Lewis and Lamb Chop to capture the excitement of the moment with Bells in the Air.
Ding dong.
In the air, chimes in the steeple, merrily clamoring the day away.
Bells everywhere, come all ye people,
come let us celebrate the holiday. Time to be merry, drink elderberry, sing your carols loud and clear. Time to be cheerful, laugh me an earful, Christmas comes but once a year.
Bells, what a thrill.
Wintertime weather, bells in the country and in every town.
If you be serious, hear them together,
turning the spirit of the world around. Santa's flight was late last night, tiny little bells were on his sleigh.
Came the dawn and he was gone, but still you can hear them.
We return Evan Bayer, Kenny Rogers, and Santa Claus sledding into Herald Square. Be there. NBC's telecast of Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade is being sponsored in part by Cotton Incorporated, who wishes you and your family peace and joy in the holiday season. The new Braun hand blender, It purees, chops, and mixes. This bronze gonna be big. And by Fujifilm. Fujifilm, a new way of seeing things.
And welcome back to the 70th annual Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade here live on NBC from New York, New York. You having a good time, Willard?
I'm having fun, and I just want to have a personal note out there to Cotton Incorporated, our sponsor, for making Long Johns. Because if they hadn't, we'd all be in Lenox Hill Hospital right now.
And I have two pairs on this morning, as a matter of fact. And even though it's cold outside, everybody is hot to trot to participate in this parade.
And we'll peel them off and go have our Thanksgiving. I smell turkey cooking somewhere. I think it's Al Roker. Are you over there bottling in the bird of it? Come here to me. Welcome back. Oh, we've already done that. To this great tradition. Football is Thanksgiving. This is Pat Summer. Oh, wrong network. Anyway, check it out on NBC. Great NFL action. The Kansas City Chiefs take on the Detroit Lions on most of these same NBC stations. And here's a different kind of holiday stuffing right now. Stocking stuffers with real live clowns.
And provided by the Family Channel just in time to celebrate the holidays, meet the Snow Family, Macy's first animated cold air inflatables. Mom, Dad, and Junior. Their combined height is over 60 feet tall.
Wow! Holy Toledo! Is that, do I go on? Dad's carrot nose could keep this Peter Rabbit balloon happy all winter, Katie. It's 3.5 feet long. That's a nose. Your turn.
Willard trying to keep warm just beneath the towering Snow Family is a man who has stood tall in American music for 3 decades. His present to us this season is a new album called The Gift. Let's listen as Kenny Rogers sings Till the Season Comes Round Again.
Come and gather round at table in the spirit of family and friends, and we'll all join hands and remember this moment till the season comes round again. May the new year be blessed with good tidings. Till the next time I see you again, and we'll all join hands and remember this moment, and we'll love and we'll laugh in the time that we have till the season comes round again. If we must say goodbye, let the spirit go with you till the season comes round again.
Kenny Rogers here. Willard, incidentally, have you bought my Christmas present yet?
Can we get the door off the hinges in your apartment? Because I'm going to take a little room. Better call the crew.
Sounds fascinating. If not, I will settle for Evan Bear in my stocking. He's the cutest bear. He's visiting us from his home in Boston. This is his second Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
He is so cute. All right, Kenny, but I'll tell you what. The bare fact is that at 58 feet high, Evan can almost peek through the Macy's toy department windows on the 7th floor.
While he fills parade fans and viewers with holiday joy, colossally cuddly Evan is filled with close to 19,000 cubic feet of helium. It would take a circle of 40 kids to give Evan a complete bear hug.
Following Evan from Boston into Herald Square is the pride of Boston University, the sound of the proud Boston Terrier marching band.
Like Evan, they're back for their second Macy's Parade, and they represent the 11 colleges and schools at Boston University.
And they
do it with flair and style, Kenny. Take a look at, take a listen.
The man of the moment, Santa is here, and so is the 1996 holiday season.
It's official, Katie. The crowds are going wild. This is fantastic, sports fans.
What a picture, Willard. Santa dashing through the snow in his beautiful sleigh shaped like a snow goose. And what about those 8 not-so-tiny reindeer? 12 feet tall, actually.
I love those kids dressed up as trees and candy canes. And elves and gnomes, they tell it all, Katie. The miracle on 34th Street continues.
Amen, Willard. Amen.
Hallelujah. I think I hurt myself on that last line.
When the kindly old gentleman in the red suit arrives, the holidays are here. It's official now.
That's terrific. It really is. And I'm all set for it. I mean, I think maybe Al and Jean should cut the ribbon and start all over again.
I don't think so, but I'll tell you, it's really been great. I feel like family now. I got 2 parades under my belt, so it feels like it's all home with you.
And a much smaller belt this year, too,
you
Al.
You look beautiful.
And you as well, Willard.
Thank you. I hope so. Thanks for noticing. Anyway, all of you out there with children, we love you so much, and thanks for watching. And, I mean, Thanksgiving is that time to go home and cook the turkey for the family.
That's right, Willard. Look at Santa waving to the crowds. Obviously, this is the high point of the parade, although I think there's so many high points. While Santa should get the lion's share of attention, I think everybody did a terrific job this year.
Think of a group, and you see all those kids out there. They're just so excited seeing Santa. And I have to say hi to my daughter, Courtney. She's homesick. She wanted to be here.
Oh, poor Courtney. Well, we miss her. And Ellie is here this year. At age 5, it's really the first year she can actually truly enjoy the parade and all the excitement.
And the crowd is absolutely fabulous, and the sun has come out. It really has been a perfect parade. It's not been that cold, and again, the big factor is that there was no wind, and that made it superb.
That's right. We had no balloon casualties this year.
That's right.
Which we like.
Yes, oftentimes the wind blows the balloons a bit and creates a lot of problems, but luckily this year, they're all safe and sound. For Willard, Al, Macy's, and NBC's, to you and yours, a warm and happy and healthy Thanksgiving.
God bless. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy holidays from Macy's and NBC. This is Don Pardo speaking.